this episode, we're going to take you through some key things you need to know about going ashore at a port. We're going to take you through what you need to pack. We're going to take you through many of the tips to make sure you're prepared to have the best travel experience possible. That's coming up.
We're Kelly and Jason, exploring the world one cruise ship at a time. Our goal is to give you the details that you need by capturing as much as we possibly can on camera, and hopefully bringing you some laughs along the way. Welcome to the Travel Scouts family.
One key tip for going aboard at a port of call that we can't stress enough is to make sure that you have your important documents. You know, we all think, hey, we're gonna make it back on ship and there's gonna be no problems, but you never know when accidents, emergencies, or unexpected things may occur. So you wanna make sure you're prepared for that. So if you're traveling with a passport, make sure you have that. Make sure you have a credit card with you or something that if you have to coordinate transportation, airfare to get back home because you were not able to make it back on the ship, have all those items to take care of the unexpected. One key tip when you're going aboard at a port of call is to make sure you know the back on board time. They will have this posted on your newsletter. They'll also usually do an announcement, and you can always make sure that you ask the staff if you're not aware, and you don't want to miss that time. You don't want to be the dock runner waving as your ship sails away. Know the back on board time. When you go aboard at a port of call, it is super important that you know the ship time. The ship time usually coincides with the departure port that you began your cruise from, but many times when you go to ports of call, they're operating on a different time zone. So your ship is not going based upon that new time zone, they're based upon that ship time. So make sure you have your clock set to that. Your phones, look, your phones may auto correct to the time zone that you're in, so know that. So know that you have a way to monitor that ship time. One huge tip when you go ashore at a port of call is to bring cash. When you get into various places, you'll have people who will be your guides, you have people that will be transportation, and while they won't be necessarily asking for tips or anything like that, many people will tip them, and so you definitely want to just have that available so you have that option. So it's always a good idea to have some cash on hand. We would highly recommend to consider booking your own excursions. And in fact, one of the things that we've begun to do when we're vlogging cruises is that we do just that. We'll go on our own and we try to show you all the stuff you need to know for getting transportation, for the booking, and every bit of that. We do a Q&A segment for those as well, because I know a lot of times if you don't travel out of country a lot, it can maybe be a little anxiety with what's that like and scared of scams and stuff like that. But it's so easy to do, and you will save money.
Yeah, and when you're booking your excursion and you're not going through your cruise line, just make sure and go to a place like TripAdvisor or something. Look at that excursion group, see what the reviews are on it, so you know exactly if it's a reputable company or not before you book. And also, a lot of these excursion companies now are also doing a guarantee that they will have you back on your ship, because I know that's one of the things a lot of people book with Carnival, because Carnival guarantees, hey, the ship will not leave you. But these other outside excursion groups are now starting to do the same thing, and so if they're responsible for you missing the ship, then they will be responsible to get you back on the ship.
So one tip that we love about going aboard at a port of call when you're doing excursions or anywhere going aboard is to keep the luggage tags on your carry-on bags or whatever backpack you're taking ashore. And here's why. If for some reason you end up leaving this somewhere and all of your transport and all of that, just simply having that luggage tag for your ship increases the chances so much to get that back to you in some way. And we have these little luggage tags that we get. This is actually, believe it or not, a super number one bestseller for preparing for cruises. So we have that link down below in our description, but something we definitely love, so glad that we have, and maybe useful for you as well.
Another really important tip at your ports of call is make sure you've got your appropriate clothing. For example, it may rain, so bring a rain jacket, or you might get really cold, so make sure you have a sweatshirt. If you like me, I love leggings. So just plan for the appropriate weather. So here's a tip: when you go to your port of call, make sure you eat before you get off the ship. It'll save you some money. Don't forget the ice cream. Another thing that you may want to consider is bringing some water shoes. A lot of times you'll be at a beach and sometimes they're rocky, so water shoes will make it a whole lot more comfortable.
When you're at port and you're doing a little shopping to bring those souvenirs back from that port of call, one thing we would say is don't be afraid to haggle a little bit. Now it's going to depend at which port you're at, and you're going to have to sort of take in sort of the area and the kind of store, but the mom and pop stores and the little just sort of like open market kind of areas, don't be afraid afraid to sort of haggle with the price, especially as it gets later in the day and cruise passengers are about to leave. That's a good opportunity. Yep. This is the Queen Haggler, so if you got any kind of thoughts on that.
Definitely wait till the end of the day. That's the key.
So one thing we would definitely recommend when coming on a cruise is to bring comfortable walking shoes. Even if you're on a smaller ship, they're bigger than you would think. You're going to be walking back and forth from your staterooms, you're out to entertainment, and to dining. So you want to make sure you have that. Even when you go to ports, you're lots of distance on piers. Anything you would like to add to that?
I actually thought you were going to say bring a razor.
No.
I thought it was a tip for not to forget a razor.
Look, if you're with us for the first time, Kelly and I, we're not psycho and we are not drugged up, but we do love to have a good time. And so we have a blast. We love taking you guys with us. But in all seriousness, the comfortable walking shoes, that will be a credit to you to bring a pair. You'll find that you will wear them and others on the cruise ship will wear them all the time. So make sure you enjoy your cruise.
And hey, don't forget to bring a razor.
No.